Good morning. Today I am starting the lecture now with Poisson's and Laplace equations. And that is lecture number 4 under electromagnetic field theory 18EE 45. So what is Poisson's and Laplace equation? So first one is from point form of Gauss law. You know divergence of D can be written as minus rho in rho, that is volume charge density. And what is electric flux density? That is D vector equal to epsilon into E. Okay. So further, divergence of D can be written as this D vector, that is nothing but epsilon into E, will be equal to minus rho V. Hence, this is a constant. So we can get divergence of electric field intensity will be nothing but rho V by epsilon. And electric field intensity E is nothing but we know it is minus del V. Okay. So hence divergence of field E is nothing but minus del V. So divergence of minus del V is equal to rho V by epsilon. So direct substitution of del V over this E field. Okay. So divergence of gradient will become del square. Del dot del is nothing but del square. So it becomes minus del square V equal to rho V by epsilon, or it can be stated as del square V is equal to minus rho V by epsilon. So this equation is known as Poisson's equation, that is del square V equal to minus rho V by epsilon. If volume charge density is zero, then del square V will be equal to zero. This is known as Laplace equation. So the two equation, that is Poisson's and Laplace equations, are nothing but del square V equal to minus rho V by epsilon is considered as Poisson's equation. Further, del square V equal to zero is known as Laplace equation. Okay. So this is Poisson's and this one is Laplace equation. So what is this del square in Cartesian? We'll try to find out. Okay. So indirectly we know Cartesian del is nothing but dou by dou x into ax cap, and further dou by dou y into ay cap plus dou by dou z into az cap. Or del v will be equal to dou v by dou x into ax cap, that is gradient of potential, can be written like this. Okay. What is divergence of del? So this del multiplied by divergence, okay, del dot del, that results in dou square by dou x square into v, that is partial second order partial differential equation del square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square of potential v, okay, which is nothing but del square v. This is the equation in the Cartesian. Okay. What is del square V in cylindrical? It is 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into dou V by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square V by dou phi square plus dou square by dou z square of potential V. This is the del square V in cylindrical system. Then what is del square V in spherical system? It is 1 by r square dou by dou r of r square dou V by dou R plus 1 by R square sin theta dou by dou theta of sin theta into dou V by dou theta plus 1 by R square sin square theta into dou square by dou square dou phi square of potential V. Okay, this is in spherical coordinate system. Okay. Further, you all have to remember this del square V in Cartesian form, del square V in cylindrical, and del square V in the spherical. Okay. Remembering Cartesian, it's straightforward, it is simple, but for cylindrical and spherical, further you people have to work out little bit. Okay. Let us consider one problem here, that is verify whether the potential field given below satisfies Laplace equation. Okay. What is Laplace equation? Del square V equal to zero. Okay. Hence, the potential V is given, the expression is given for potential field. We have to find out what is del square V. Okay. So what is del square V? In Cartesian, since the problem is in Cartesian, it is dou square by dou x square of v plus dou square by dou x square of v plus dou square by dou z square of v. That means this whole thing should be differentiated twice with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z. Okay, differentiation of this with respect to x twice will become, first time differentiation it is 4x, and this is a constant 0, this will be constant 0. Again differentiation of 4x will become 4. So this will become 4, that is what has been written. So in differentiation of this twice with respect to y, this only this term will contribute, so it will become twice differentiation, it will be minus 6. And differentiation of this whole thing twice with respect to z, first time differentiation it will result in 2z, again differentiation will result in 2. Hence the answer will become 4 minus 6 plus 2, which will result in 0. Okay, hence del square v will be equal to 0. That means this potential field satisfies the Laplace equation. So in this problem, this v satisfies Laplace equation, where it is resulting as del square v equal to 0. Let us consider one more problem, that is second problem. Calculate numerical values for potential v and volume charge density rho v at point P in free space. Okay. Part A in this, if v equal to 4yz divided by x square plus 1 at point P with coordinates 1, 2, 3, we have to find out what is v and the volume charge density. Okay. First thing, let us find out what is the potential at point P. By direct substituting that xyz value, it results in 12 volts. Okay. Then, in order to find out the volume charge density, let us try to recollect, that is del square V equal to minus rho V by epsilon, that is the Poisson's equation. Okay. Using that, we will try to find out the volume charge density rho V. Okay. So what is del square V in Cartesian system? We know it is equal to dou square V by dou x square plus dou square V by dou y square plus dou square V by dou z square. Okay. So we have to differentiate this with respect to x twice, with respect to y twice. So by doing that first time differentiation with respect to x, it results in this form 4yz into this. Okay. Again differentiating dou square V by dou x square will result in this form. Okay. Similarly, what we have to do now, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to y twice, but there is only 4y is there. So differentiation of first time differentiating this will become y power 0. Again trying to differentiate, there is no y here, second time differentiation, so this will result as dou square v by dou y square will result in 0. Similarly, dou square v by dou z square will result in 0. Okay, that has been written here. Dou square v by dou y square is 0, and also dou square v by dou z square is 0. Hence del square v will be only due to dou square v by dou x square, which is this, which can be equated by using Poisson's equation, that is minus rho v by epsilon. So by doing that and cross multiplying with epsilon naught, rho v at point P by substituting x, y, z values, we get volume charge density at point P will be 106.2 picocoulomb per meter cube. That means this is the volume charge density. Further, we'll take the part B in this problem, that is potential V will be equal to 5 rho square into cos 2 phi at point P, coordinates have been given. This is the problem in the cylindrical coordinate system. Okay. Further, we have to consider, let us find out what is potential V at point P, that is 5 into rho square into cos phi. What is given in the problem? Cos 2 phi. So by substituting those rho value as 3 and phi value as pi by 3, we get potential V at point P will be equal to minus 22.5 volts. So this is the potential at point P. Okay. Further, let us try to find out what is del square V. Okay. What is del square V in cylindrical system? It is 1 by rho 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into dou v by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square v by dou phi square plus dou square v by dou z square. That means, first what we'll do, we'll try to find out this dou v by dou rho. Which result, what is v? V is nothing but 2 phi rho square cos 2 phi, okay. By substituting that, this and differentiating with respect to rho, it will become 10 rho into cos 2 phi. And this one has to be multiplied by rho and then again differentiate with respect to rho, okay. So once you multiply and then differentiate with respect to rho, further it will be resulted as, further it will be resulted as, where I have tried to consider here this 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into this, okay. And also we have done here dou v by dou phi, which is resulted in differentiation with respect to phi. Cos 2 phi has become sin 2 phi, and this is the answer we have got. And substituting that for del square v, okay, further we get the answer as 0 here. Hence, this del square v equal to 0, which that means the volume charge density also will be equal to 0. So let us try to consider the third part in this problem. So what is v is given here? It is 2 cos phi by r square, okay. And by looking at these coordinates, this is the problem given in a spherical coordinate system. So again, we have to consider the del square v in a spherical coordinate system, that is 1 by r square dou by dou r of this plus 1 by r square sin theta dou by dou theta of this plus 1 by r square sin square theta dou square v by dou phi square, okay. So and then doing a differentiation, so substituting for potential v and then differentiating with respect to r, and potential v differentiating with respect to phi, potential v differentiating with respect to theta, we get something like this, wherein further del square v is nothing but substituting for the, in this further in the, this equation we get del square v at point p will be 2 by r power 4 minus 2 by r power 4, okay. So again this will be resulting as answer 0, hence volume charge density will be 0, okay. So what we have tried to consider in this problem is, it has been taken a problem on Cartesian system, cylindrical system and also on the spherical coordinate system, and trying to find out what is the potential at point P as well as the volume charge density by knowing or by considering del square V. So let us further consider applying Laplace equation. Obtain the expression for E field in Cartesian system between two parallel plates separated by a distance d applied between them, and also find the capacitance, okay. So in the previous lecture you might have seen what is the parallel plate of a capacitor, where it is equal to epsilon s by d, okay. Let us use by solving Laplace equation, we'll try to get the same equation expression in this lecture now. So Laplace equation is nothing but del square v equal to 0, okay. So let us consider the, if the potential is a function of only z, you can take it as in this manner, okay. So then integrating this with respect to z, this equation with respect to z. So first time integration, this will become dou v by dou z, which is equal to c1, okay. Further again integration of this will result in potential v equal to c1 into z plus c2, where c1 and c2 are the two constants, okay. So by using these boundary condition, we'll try to find out what are these two constant, okay. One of the boundary condition is at z equal to 0, potential is 0, okay. One more is at z equal to d, potential is v0, okay. Using these two boundary condition, we get c2 equal to 0, and what about c1? C1 will result as v0 by d. Hence, potential will become V0 by D into, it is in the Z direction. So, that is V will be equal to V0 by D into z, okay, where potential, the electric field intensity is nothing but minus gradient of potential. Hence minus, and what is gradient? Dou v by dou x into ax cap and so on. So this gives you electric field intensity as v naught by d into az cap. Okay, once we get electric field intensity, next step is finding the flux density. Okay, so just multiplying this by epsilon, electric flux density results as epsilon v naught by d. Okay, so what is capacitance? It is nothing but q divided by v. Okay, so charge q is nothing but surface charge density into ds, are nothing but it result as the flux density multiplied by surface area. Okay, so hence the capacitance is nothing but charge q divided by v naught, so which results as here the v naught is there and here we got the charge by using this flux density, and capacitance is q by v, which is nothing but epsilon in s by d. Okay, so in the previous lecture, whatever the capacitance we have got for the two parallel plates, same capacitance we have got by solving the Laplace equation. Okay, so first thing is, in the Laplace equation we'll try to find out the potential. From the potential we'll find out the electric field intensity. Once you get the field, it is flux. Once you get the flux, it is nothing but the charge. Next, after charge, it is the last step is finding the capacitance. Next, we'll try to find out the same the capacitance for the cylindrical capacitor. Okay, so same thing, in the previous we have got the capacitance directly. Here by solving Laplace equation we try to find the capacitance. Okay, so let us assume the here this in the cylindrical coordinate system, let us take if the potential is in the direction of rho, so del square v can be written only the first term, that is 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into dou v by dou rho. So Laplace equation, this del square v is equal to 0. Okay, further integrating this term twice, okay, with respect to rho, we get it as it is nothing but it will be equal to v equal to c1 into log rho plus c2. Okay, where c1 and c2 are constant. Again, using these initial conditions, we can find these these constants. At rho equal to b, potential is 0. So taking this condition, we get the c2 value equal to minus c1 into log b. One more initial condition is at rho equal to a, potential v is v naught. Using these two, we get c1 as v naught divided by log a by b. So we got now c1 and c2, hence potential v is v naught divided by log a by b into log rho minus v naught into this. Okay, hence once we get the potential v, next is we have to find out the electric field intensity e vector. Okay, so what is e vector? It is nothing but minus del v. Okay, e vector is nothing but minus del v. Okay, so this is potential v, and differentiating this potential v with respect to rho phi z and multiplying by the respective coordinates, we get the electric field intensity. Anyway, v is a function of only rho here. Let us do only this. So we get e vector equal to v naught divided by rho into log v by a rho cap. Okay, further, once we get electric field intensity, straightforward, let us find out what is flux density, epsilon into e. Once you get the flux density, next step is charge q. It is surface charge density multiplied by the area. Area of one of the conductor we can consider as 2 pi into a. A is the radius of the inner conductor into l. L is the length of the conductor. So the once we get the charge q, next step is capacitance, which is nothing but q by v naught. So which results as 2 pi epsilon l divided by log v by a. Okay, hence again it is same steps. So something similar to the previous one, where the capacitance of parallel plate is epsilon s by d. Here the capacitance of coaxial cable is nothing but 2 pi epsilon l divided by log b by a. Next, let us try to find out the capacitance between two concentric spherical spheres of radii a and b. where b is the radius of the outer spherical conductor and a is the radius of the inner conductor. Okay, using Laplace equation, further let us assume the potential v is a function of only radius r, hence del square v equal to 0, which will result in only this term equal to 0. Again, integrating this term twice with respect to radius r, it will result with these two constants c1 and c2, which will be nothing but v equal to minus c1 by r plus c2. Okay, by using the two initial conditions of at r equal to b, potential is 0, and at r equal to a, potential equal to v0, we get the two constants c1 and c2. Okay, hence potential v0 will be equal to by these two constants c1 and c2, it becomes potential v0 will be equal to so much. Okay, it is v0 by r into this, and this is the constant. Okay, so further, what is electric field intensity? It is nothing but minus del v. Okay, so by differentiating this term with respect to radius r, we get minus dou v by dou r into ar cap. Okay, anyway, it is not a function of theta and phi. Let us not do this. Hence, it becomes the electric field intensity is nothing but 1 by r square into this. Okay, once we get electric field intensity, next step is electric flux density, where d vector is epsilon into e. Okay, further, it goes as epsilon into v naught divided by r square into 1 by a minus 1 by b. Okay, so this is nothing but surface charge density. Once you get the flux density, next thing is charge q. Q is nothing but surface charge density multiplied by area of the sphere. Area of the inner sphere is 4 pi a square. So rho s into 4 pi a square is nothing but the charge q. So where capacitance is q by v naught. So the substitution of q and v naught will result as capacitance C equal to 4 pi epsilon divided by 1 by a minus 1 by b. So we have got the same result of the capacitor in the previous lecture, whatever you have heard. So we have got now capacitance of parallel plate, and then the capacitance of a coaxial cable, and the capacitance of the spherical sphere. We'll further consider one more fourth problem, that is, there are semi-infinite planes for phi equal to 0 and phi equal to alpha, which are separated by a very small insulating gap, okay, as shown in this figure. If V, potential V at phi equal to 0 is 0 volts, and potential V at phi equal to alpha is V naught, calculate voltage and field intensity in the region between the planes, okay. So here, by solving Laplace equation, we have to find out the potential voltage and the field intensity. Okay, so let us consider this problem as in the cylindrical coordinates, or it can be taken even in the spherical. Okay, so here it has been taken in cylindrical, where del square V is 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into dou V by dou rho, okay, plus 1 by rho square dou square V by dou phi square plus dou square V by dou z square. This is nothing but del square V using Laplace equation, it is equal to 0. Okay, but here the problem, V is a function of phi. Okay, so let us consider only this second term equal to 0. Okay, that is dou square V by dou phi square equal to 0. Okay, and then integrating this term twice with respect to phi, we get potential V equal to c1 phi plus c2. Okay, and using the two conditions given here in the problem, v at phi equal to 0 and v at phi equal to alpha, using these two conditions, we can find out the constants c1 and c2, where c2 will result in answer 0 and c1 will result the answer as v0 by alpha. Hence, potential v will become v0 by alpha multiplied by phi, okay, where alpha is the inclined angle between the two plates. Okay, so where the field intensity E can be found as minus del into del of V. Okay, so in cylindrical coordinates, del V can be written in this manner. Okay, again, V is a function of only phi. So let us consider only the second term. The first term and third term become 0. So So E field will result in this manner. Okay. So in this problem, the question is potential has been asked, which we have got here, and the field intensity which has been resulted here. Next, let us consider one more problem. Given the potential field V equal to A into rho power 4 plus B into rho power minus 4 sine 4 phi, show that del square V equal to 0. So this is the first part of the problem, where the point P is given as rho phi z values are given. Okay. First, what is del square V? Let us write in a cylindrical coordinate system. Here, V is a function of rho as well as phi, okay? So that means we have to find out this 1 by rho dou by dou rho of this plus 1 by rho square dou square V by dou phi square. Okay? So these two we have to find out. So first, doing dou V by dou rho, it results differentiation of this with respect to rho results in this 4a rho cube. Rho power minus 4 differentiation is minus 4 rho power minus 5. And then it has to be multiplied by rho. This answer should be multiplied by rho. Again, differentiation with rho. And again, after that, again multiply by 1 by rho. Doing that in this here. So first, let us multiply this one by rho. It becomes 4a rho power 4 and so on. Okay. And then differentiating the further, it results in this equation. And then multiplying by 1 by rho, it results in this equation number 1. Okay. Further, what is there here? It is dou V by dou phi square. Okay. So differentiation of potential V with respect to phi twice, partial differentiation. So by doing that, dou square V by dou phi square, we get it as minus 16 A into rho power 4, direct differentiation with respect to phi twice. It results in this equation number 2. Okay. So by adding equation number 1, plus equation number 2 and then multiplying the 2 by 1 by rho square, it results this answer, which will be equal to 0. Hence, we can tell del square V equal to 0. Hence, it indicates that this potential field V, what is given in this problem, is equal to 0. Okay. Let us try to consider the second part in this problem. Select A and B so that potential V is 100 volts. And magnitude of E vector is 500 volt per meter at point P. Okay, so they are telling what is these constants A and B we have to find out, wherein the potential is 100 volts and the E field magnitude is 500 volt per meter. So V and E is given. We have to find out this value of A and B, these two constants. Okay. So for this part B, let us find out what is potential V at point P. By knowing rho phi z value, direct substitution, it gives A plus B equal to 100. Okay. What is electric field intensity? It is nothing but minus del V. Okay. So differentiation of this potential V with respect to rho phi z in this del V, we get E vector equal to this answer. Okay. Further, this E magnitude has been given. Okay. As we know, this we'll try to find out the magnitude here. So 500 will be equal to, from this equation, E vector at point P by this equation, equating to this magnitude will result in this. Okay. So now there are two equations. One is A plus B equal to 100 because of E vector at point P. One more is in this potential. That is A plus B equal to 100 due to potential. And this A minus B multiplied by minus 4 equal to 500 due to E field. So using these two equations, and two unknowns are there and two equations are there, by solving this we can find out what is A and B. So A will result in minus 12.5 and B will result in 112.5. Okay. So by solving these two equations, we get A and B. Let us consider one more problem, that is region in free space, the volume charge density is constant along x direction between x equal to 0 and x equal to 1 meter. Conditions for region are potential V equal to 0 at x equal to 0 and potential V equal to 500 volts at x equal to 1 meter. obtain the potential function and hence calculate the voltage at x equal to 0.5 meter. Okay, so they have given the condition and the distance of separation they have given. Okay, we have to find out somewhere in the middle what is the potential at x equal to 0.5 meter. So let us consider the Poisson's equation here, del square V equal to minus rho V by epsilon. Okay. So in the Cartesian system, it is dou square V by dou x square because V is a function of only x. Let us take only the first term. So and then it is equal to minus rho V by epsilon. Okay. Integrating this with respect to x twice, okay, we get the two constants. We get something like this. V equal to minus rho V by epsilon x square by 2 plus C1 x plus C2. Okay, this is the equation. So by using the conditions, whatever has been given, by solving that, we get C2 equal to 0. And further C1, by using this condition, x equal to 1 meter at V equal to 500 volts, using this, we get C1 constant equal to this. Okay. So by getting C1 and C2, we can substitute in this equation where potential V is nothing but this. Okay, but what is the question? At x equal to 0.5 meter, we have to find out this potential V. Okay, substituting C1, C2 and x as 0.5 and the volume charge density has been given in the question. By substituting the data, we get it as potential at 0.5 meter, we get it as minus 13.87 into 10 power 3 volts or minus 13.87. Now, let us consider something important theorem in this Laplace and Poisson's continuation, that is uniqueness theorem. Okay. For this uniqueness theorem, we'll state the uniqueness theorem later. Let us try to see what is this all about. Okay. First thing is, let us assume there are two solutions or Laplace equation V1 and V2. Okay. So in any system, let us assume that if there are two Laplace equations, which are two solutions for the Laplace equation V1 and V2. If these two V1 and V2 are satisfying Laplace equation, then we can write it as del square V equal to 0 or del square V1 equal to 0 and also del square V2 equal to 0. Or we can state it as del square V1 minus V2 will be equal to 0. Okay. That means this potential del square V1 as well as del square V2 both must satisfy the boundary condition. Okay. If we represent the given potential values on the boundaries by VB, suppose, then the value of V1 on the boundary is V1B and the value of V2 on the boundary is V2B. Okay. On the boundary, this V1B and V2B must be identical. Hence, V1B minus V2B will be equal to 0 on the boundary. Okay. Let us consider one vector identity, that is divergence of a scalar multiplied by a vector will be equal to scalar into divergence of a vector plus del of the scalar dot del into the vector. Okay, so that is, suppose we consider del dot v1 minus v2 into del of v1 minus v2. Okay, this is a vector and this is a scalar. Okay, it will be equal to V1 minus V2 into divergence of this vector. Okay, plus del of scalar dot with a vector. Okay, so what we have taken here is V1 minus V2 as a scalar, gradient of V1 minus V2 as considered as a vector. So using a vector identity, divergence of a scalar into vector as scalar into divergence of vector plus a gradient of scalar dot product with vector. Okay, so this, using this vector identity, integrating this equation over a volume, okay, what can be written as volume integral divergence of V1 minus V2 into del of V1 minus V2 over a differential volume. Okay, on the right hand side, again applying the volume integral on the first term and the second term, we can write these two things. Okay, Let us consider this whole thing as equation number one. Okay, applying the volume integral on this vector identity, we can write like this. Okay. Further, applying the divergence theorem on the LHS. Okay, by applying the divergence theorem on LHS. Okay, if you apply the divergence theorem on LHS, this equation del dot d into dv can be written as. And the volume integral can be taken as surface integral. Okay, divergence of d vector is closed surface integral d dot ds. Okay, by using that we can write it as volume integral is taken as surface integral, this divergence of v1 minus v2 into del dot del into v1 minus v2 can be written as this whole thing is vector. So v1b minus v2b into del of v1b minus v2b dot product with differential surface area vector. Okay, but on the boundary this v1b is equal to v2b. Okay, hence this term will result in zero. Okay, that means the equation number one LHS will be equal to zero. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll consider the right hand side of the equation or equation number one, RHS of the equation number one. What is there in the RHS of the equation number one? It is this first term plus this second term. Okay, so in the first term it is volume integral v1 minus v2 into del dot v1 minus v2 into differential volume. Okay, one of the first integral on RHS of equation one is del dot v1 minus v2, or it can be written as del square v1 minus v2. Okay, right, it is nothing but it is here del dot del is nothing but del square. Okay, so del square of v1 minus v2, but initially we have seen in the beginning of this theorem del square of v1 minus v2 is equal to zero on the boundary. Hence this RHS, one of the first term on the RHS also will become zero. Okay, that means what is remaining in the equation number one, that is only the term, that is the last second term, that is volume integral del of v1 minus v2 whole square over a differential volume, this will be resulting as zero. Okay, that means this one will result as either this integral should be zero, or this integrand over some part it should be positive and over some part it should be negative. But since you have a whole square, this whole thing cannot become a negative. Hence what you can tell is this integrand will be equal to zero. Hence del of v1 minus v2 whole square is equal to zero, or del of v1 minus v2 will be equal to zero. Hence if del of v1 minus v2 equal to 0, that means what is del? Del is nothing but a differentiation. Okay, so differentiation of some term, if it is 0, that means this term is nothing but a constant. Hence we can tell v1 minus v2 will be equal to a constant. Okay, that means this is stated as equation number 2. So equation must 2 must hold everywhere including at the boundary. But over the boundary, what is this v1 and v2? It will be same. It is equals, and which is equal to, that means this v1 and v2 over the boundary, it is same. So that is v1 minus v2 will be resulting as zero. Okay, on the boundary, if it is v1 and v2 are equal, that means it should be same. Further, everywhere within the system, hence this v1 must be equal to v2 everywhere. So hence, what is uniqueness theorem is stating that if there is a solution which satisfies these boundary condition, then that solution is unique. Okay, there will be only one solution, there won't be more than one solution if it is satisfying the boundary condition. Okay, so the uniqueness theorem states that if a solution to Laplace equation or Poisson's equation can be found which satisfies the boundary condition, then that solution is unique. Okay, this is nothing but the uniqueness theorem. Okay, so initially it has been considered as If there are two different solution, if there are two solution V1 and V2, on the boundary it must be same, but further it has been resulted as V1 minus V2 must be constant throughout the system, where V1 will become V2, and that means that the solution is unique. Okay, if it is satisfying the boundary condition, this is known as uniqueness theorem. Further, we'll consider one more problem now. Find E vector at point P with coordinates 3, 1, 2 for the field of part A in this two coaxial conducting cylinders with potential V equal to 500 volts and rho equal to 2 meter and potential V equal to 20 volts at rho equal to 3 meters. So these are the two conditions given. We have to find out E vector magnitude at point P. So this is the problem. Though they have given V is a function of rho, but point P is given in Cartesian. Okay, so this must be converted into cylindrical these coordinates and then substitute and do it. So del square V is nothing but in cylindrical coordinate system, it is 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho into dou V by dou rho equal to 0, Laplace equation. So integrating this with respect to rho twice, it will result as potential V equal to C1 log rho plus C2. Okay. And there are two conditions here, rho equal to 2 meter and rho equal to 3 meters. Okay. Using that at rho equal to 2 meter of V equal to 50 volts and one more condition at rho equal to 3 meter potential is 20 volts. Using these two initial conditions, we get C1 and C2. C1 and C2 will result as one equation is 20 C1 log rho plus C2. By solving this equation number 1 and equation number 2, C1 we get it as, we get C1 equal to minus 74.07, and further C2 will be resulting in 0. Hence electric field intensity is nothing but minus del V, which is nothing but minus C1 1 by rho, and C1 is here by substituting that, and field intensity at point P will result as 23.4 volt per meter. The substitution for E field as minus del V, which is nothing but minus dou V by dou rho into A rho cap. So differentiating V with respect to rho and then substituting the C1 and rho value, where for the rho value is nothing but it is root of x square plus y square. Here the question is, the point P is in Cartesian system. Okay, so the in the cylinder we have to convert this Cartesian values into cylindrical coordinates. Okay, where the cylindrical coordinate rho will be equal to root of this x square plus y square, that is 3 square plus 1 square. Okay, so one small change here is the point P is given in Cartesian, that must be converted into cylindrical coordinates. Okay, so E at point P will result as 2.34 volt per meter. We'll take the part B in this problem, that is part B is two radial conducting planes, V equal to 50 volts at phi equal to 10 degrees and V equal to 20 volts at phi equal to 30 degrees. We have to find out the field E at point P for this given system. Okay, so here again the problem can be considered in either in cylindrical system or it's in spherical system, because the angle phi is given. Okay, so here the problem is taken in a cylindrical system. It is 1 by rho square dou square V by dou phi square equal to 0 using Laplace equation. And again, integrating this equation twice with respect to angle phi, we get it as two potential V will be equal to C1 phi plus C2. Okay. And by using the two initial condition, the equation will result as, that is what has been given here is, in the problem, It is given as V equal to 50 at phi equal to 10 degrees using this condition, and V equal to 20 at phi equal to 30 degrees using these two initial condition. It will be result as the two equation by substituting this in this equation. It will result equation number 1 and 2. Okay. By solving this equation number 1 and 2, we can find out what is C1 and C2. Okay. Further, we get C1 as minus 85.98, which is a constant. Okay. Then, once we get this potential V, and we have to find out using this the electric field intensity. What is E vector? E vector is minus gradient of potential. So, in cylindrical system, it is only taking the second term, because V is a function of phi, it will become 1 by rho into dou V by dou phi A phi cap. Okay. So, by differentiating this with respect to phi, it will become only C1 into A phi cap multiplied by this minus 1 by rho. Okay. And taking this rho value, and at point B, as we know, rho is nothing but root of x square plus y square. So, it will get it as E at point P will result in this answer. So much, 27.2 A phi cap. E vector is in the phi direction. Okay. So, this is almost similar to the previous. Only change here is the point P is given in the Cartesian system. That should be converted into cylindrical coordinates to find the E vector, the magnitude, the E field at point P. Okay. Further, we will consider more numericals in the repetition class. Okay. I will stop at this point, this lecture. Thank you.